The Logical Thinking Processes, presented by Bill Dettmer. Part 5, The Future Reality Tree.
So now we've seen into details the evaporating cloud, helping to remove conflicts in the resolution of a critical root cause. I guess now we need to know what's the next step, meaning what direction are we going to go?
Mm-hmm.
Because I guess we've seen the current situation and we want to go in the future.
Mm-hmm.
Now.
Yes, and you have the seeds for the solution of the complex system problem in the injections that were developed either to overcome critical root causes or to resolve the conflict. But those injections or those ideas for solutions are not really solutions until two things happen. First, they have to be verified that they are going to be effective, and the second thing is that they have to be implemented. Only then can you consider them solutions. The problem is that most people come through a problem-solving process with ideas to cure the problems, and they go directly into implementation without verifying that those solutions are actually going to deliver the desired results. It's very critical to do this because at this stage of the game, you have been doing nothing except analyzing a problem, and that's kind of a passive situation. When you get to trying to solve the problem, you're going to take action, and actions usually require the investment of resources, such as people or money, time, so forth. It would be a waste of resources to engage in an attempt to implement a solution that isn't going to produce the results. Mm-hmm. So the idea behind the future reality tree is it's kind of a tabletop exercise to determine whether or not the proposed actions are actually going to deliver the desired results, which is, in most cases, the cancellation of the undesirable effect and or the achievement of one of the critical success factors that has not been fully achieved. Another thing that it does is it allows the analyst to determine whether a new idea that you want to put into effect is actually going to create new and perhaps even more difficult problems to solve. And we refer to this as a negative branch. The intent here is to find out that you may let yourself in for more trouble than you expected before you actually do that. And the negative branch factor of the future reality tree gives you the opportunity to prevent that from happening before it actually starts to precipitate. So that's the future reality tree. It's your implementation plan for the future. And then the only thing that remains after that is execution.
Okay, so the future reality tree helps you checking that you are going into the right direction,
mm-hmm.
to achieve the goal,
mm-hmm.
and also that you're not creating a new, maybe even more severe problem.
That's true. In fact, if I had to summarize it, I would say it is a risk mitigation tool.
Okay. I think you even mentioned another very good word, which was the roadmap.
Roadmap, yes, that's true. Keeps you on the straight and narrow so that you don't get off into things that don't matter.